Into the actual battles, we've got one of our sponsors, IBM, that is going to give a quick talk to you. We've had a look at the academic side, what happens at university. Now we're going to have a look at what some of what people do in industry, particularly at IBM. So I'm going to pass the floor over to Narayana for you, and he'll discuss what he does at IBM and all the possibilities there. Would you like to welcome Narayana up?
About me, so I'm working for IBM in the Gold Coast. So we have got a beautiful lab in the South Pole, and it's a cybersecurity lab. So we develop some cybersecurity products which are really helpful. And I'm a master inventor as well, which means I have submitted a given number of patents filed with the US Patent Office, as well as I have published many articles on IP.com. And I'm a subject matter expert in cybersecurity, cloud technologies, as well as design thinking. And I believe in lifelong learning. I normally spend around 200 hours learning every year, and I do quite a bit of certification as well to keep up to date with today's technologies. And I also participate in organized hackathons. So I've been involved in a few hackathons. And I'm a mentor. So I do mentoring to graduate students at Central Queensland University. I'm also an academic ambassador, and I do talk to students and from schools. So a brief overview about IBM. How many of you know about IBM? Okay, that's quite good. So it's a very old company. It's more than 100 years. And it's a multinational with around 400,000 employees worldwide, and it's across multiple countries. So what's great about IBM? The one thing that Steve wanted me to talk about is innovation. And IBM is a strong believer in innovation, and it has been working with scientists and researchers who are part of IBM. They have patented around, in the last year, they have patented more than 9,000 US patents, and that's like the topmost number of patents in any given year. For the last 28 years, IBM has been leading that space. And to give you an example of a few patents that IBM did, so that's the link which has around 100 different IBM patents, or the technology that it, the innovation it has brought into history. So I'll talk about two of these. The first one is, how many of you use a credit card? Or seen using a credit card. So the magnetic stripe on it, that was IBM's invention, and that has speeded up the adoption of credit cards. And then the laser surgery, so you might have heard about LASIK, the eye surgery. Without destroying a lot of muscle in your eye, you're able to do accurate correction of eye related issues, and that was invented by IBM as well. And have you heard of Project Debater? It's an AI-based debater that can debate with a real human being. So not only can the AI understand and assimilate what the human is talking about, it can either talk further topic or against the topic, and it can summarize all the content that the person said, and on the fly determine how to debate with that person. this is also a patent from IBM. IBM has got a lot of AI, Watson capabilities that can do this. And IBM has recently committed to reskilling around 30 million people by the year 2030. As part of this commitment, they have got an open learning platform called skillsbuild.org. This is for students as well as job seekers. So there is a big course catalog and it covers many courses. And if you are in the age group of 13 to 18, you are welcome to check it out and do some courses. So this is a course catalog. It has got technical skills and then general skills like workspace skills, agile, design thinking, how do you go about a problem and things like that. And you can also expand your horizons around sustainability. You all know climate change is a big thing and all countries are committing for a lot of budget towards climate change. They're trying to, all enterprises are really going towards net zero carbon emission requirements. So these are the courses. I think there are hundreds of courses you can look into, and there are badges that you can get by doing the course. And these will go a long way in your career. So now I'll talk about secrets to a successful career. So I'll give you some tips and tricks on how to become successful in your career. So the first advice or technique or tip I would say is be curious. So a lot of us are using a lot of apps, right? So for example, you're using Facebook app, or you're searching something on Google, or you might be buying something on Amazon. So how does it work? How do they manage massive scale of information, or how do they manage a network of users, and how do they give you recommendations? How does Netflix work? Where do they store the data? How much data is required? How much capacity is required? What would be the CPU requirements? What would be the memory requirements? How do you scale? How do you ensure that they are available 100% of the time? So how do you manage? So how do you design for such requirements for a product that has to scale? How does gaming work? What is the internal architecture? So be curious about everything that you use in your life. And think about the design, think about the architecture, think about how do you test such a big scale of resources. So what's needed? How do you ensure that privacy is there? How do you ensure it's secure? So be curious about how stuff works. So how does Google or how does YouTube work? So we all are in the consumer space. So think about how can I produce something? So instead of being a consumer of Facebook, how do I produce something like Facebook or IBM or any of those Apple products or apps, mobile apps? So can I build a mobile app that's consumed by others? So think from a production mindset. And then goals, defining your goals is really important. So think about what you would like to be 10 years down the line. Think about a long-term career, and then think about middle term, like 5 years. And then think about 1 year. What would I be doing in 1 year's time? And then you could think about what would I do today? So what are the things I would like to do today and then tomorrow? So you can scope it according to your plan and have that goals. And the greatest problem with anything is, how do I experiment? What happens if I fail? So that fear of failure itself is stopping a lot of people from experimenting something new. Try something new. Or if you get an idea, think about how you implement this. Don't worry about the outcome of it. Don't be afraid. It's okay to fail. Like Thomas Alva Edison failed 1,000 times before inventing a light bulb. It's okay to fail. So one thing is, what you need to do, instead of fearing the failure, think about the risk. Try to assess the risk, calculate the risk involved in taking that experiment to the next level. And then, it's okay to fail. Success is just one of those failures that just got succeeded. And this is something, always we keep saying, define your goals. I would say define your fears. What would happen if I do not achieve a goal? Or what would happen if I take a step? happen if I take a particular course? List out all your fears. What is the worst thing that could happen if I do this? If I try something new, what would happen? So if you create a list of all your fears, it's easy to overcome the fear. So you know, worst case scenario, what would happen. So you don't have to worry about taking that step ahead. So defining your goals and then defining your fears, that would help you move forward. And then learn new skills. So there is something called a T model that you need to follow in your career. T model is like, you need to have a broad idea about a lot of areas. And then you should be a subject matter expert in a particular area. It's like T. So in one thing, you are the expert. So if I have to ask someone, who's the expert in this? Yeah, so you are the expert. And then you'll also have to have some idea about how things work at a broader level. So have an idea about a lot of things, but be an expert in one thing. So that's called the T model. And then for that, you need to learn new skills every day. Learn something new every day. It could be just a Hello World program. Probably you might have heard about programming languages. So just try a new programming language every day. Write a Hello World program and then if you like it, you can continue developing your skills. So that's very important, having a growth mindset and learning skills every day, staying up to date with what's happening in the world will take you a long way. So companies are really looking for the attitude towards learning. So is this person teachable? Is he willing to learn? Does he have a growth mindset? Is he afraid of something? Will he be able to take any challenges? That's what we need to think about. And then the next skill that you would like to learn is articulation. So how do I articulate my idea, or if you are supposed to explain your project, what is the best way in which you can articulate your ideas? Explain about the project in a succinct way, but clear and concise way, without a lot of confusion. So we should be able to. So that's the soft skill side of things. So you need to have communication skills, articulation skills, explaining things in a certain way, without having to go all around. You need to learn that skill. And then the next thing is embracing diversity. So we are all diverse in our own ways. So there is diversity in thought, there is diversity in ideas. There is one person, so like we have diversity everywhere, right? It's all about inclusion and diversity. So when we are forming a team, think about complementary skills. So if one person is good at analyzing a problem and one person is good at executing the solution, one person might be good at architecting a solution, or one would be good at testing a solution, one might be good at selling. So if we have a team of people who have complementary skills, so they all will complement each other and you become the best team. So try to keep yourself among smart people and you will learn from them and you will also be able to contribute to the overall team success. So embrace the diversity. It's good to have diversity within your team, so you learn from them. And you don't want everyone thinking in the same way, right? You want others to be thinking in a different way. That's how innovation happens. So you need to brainstorm with people with different skills. And you need to create a to-do list, and you also need to create a not-to-do list. So this is especially important if you are looking for productivity in your life. If you want to be productive, you need to understand what are your priorities. So everyone in this room has got only 24 hours, right? So how does one person differ from the other? So you need to think about what is the best use of your time, what are my priorities, what is my passion. You should find your passion and then try to prioritize it, put it in the to-do list, and look for what are the distractions to reach my passion, what are all distracting me from achieving my goals. And then put them in a not-to-do list, have a look at them every day, and then see that the distraction is not killing your time from doing something that's something you love to do, something that you're passionate about. And then this is another important thing in your life, so you want to divide your time into three parts. The first part is trying to spend time with people who are at the same level as you. So with your classmates. we should spend some time with your classmates and discuss and brainstorm ideas. And then we should spend some time with someone who's beyond your level, some seniors, or some or your teachers, or someone from the academy, or from someone from the enterprise, or someone who's in a position where you would like to go. So if you have a dream of becoming a cricketer, then look for a cricketer and talk to him. So because they already have been through the journey, they will know how to take you there. Or they might give you some advice on what they did. So it's easy. So have a mentor, find a mentor, and then try to also be a mentor for your juniors. That way you have to divide your time into three parts, one with a mentor, one with your mentees, and one with your classmates or people who are in the same league. Okay, I think that was my last suggestion. And we have a message from our lab director, Alan Place, who's based in London, and he's our lab director. And yeah, let's watch it.
Hi, my name's Alan Place. I'm the director of the IBM Security Lab right here in the Gold Coast. So please, if IBM is able to sponsor this event for another year, and this event just seems to go from strength to strength. Every year, more schools involved, more people involved, and I think this is the best yet. So as a sponsor, we have to dig around in our store and have a look for some merchandise, and I'm very pleased to say that we found some awesome swag. That'll be presented to the winning team later on today, and it is a competition, so good luck and may the best team win.
So that's the swag I think everyone's gonna get. That's my LinkedIn profile. If you'd like to follow me, you can contact me. Southern schools, and the winner of those two heats will play off in the grand final to see who wins the overall Capture the Flag 2021.